Good afternoon, YouTube. So I was using the Grizzly lathe today, drilling a hole, and all of a sudden the quill on the tailstock started spinning. And what had happened is it sheared off the little set screw that was down in here. There was basically a little slug of metal right down in the groove, and this thing would just spin as soon as you engaged the drill bit. So I pulled the tailstock off. I tried a small and 3mm drill bit through the hole there to see if I could get the set screw out. It's been stripped out for quite a while. I think it's a 4mm screw. I don't have any 4mm, but I found a number 10 screw will fit. So that's just slightly bigger. So I figure I'll go up one size and drill this out. I've got a number 26 drill there, so I'm going to drill down through there. I'm not sure if that's going to remove the threads or not. Okay, slight change of plans, YouTube. So to drill through on the hole, I've had to take out the lead screw in here because it extends a little bit past where the set screw goes. And you need to be able to drill through and then run your tap. I found some M6x1 set screws that I have, and I think those will work a little better. These are stronger than my 1024s. I couldn't get the tap to start in the remains of the threads of the set screw that was in there. So this is a number 9 bit, which is should be the tap size for M6x1. Yeah, now we got some cast iron out of there. Yeah, that tap should go in there. Okay, there we got the tap started. Good at cutting the cast iron. So there we go. I'll get that out and we'll test fit the screw. Okay, it looks like the screw is gonna go in there okay. So now what I need to do, let's see, I think I came up with about 0.4 inch. This is about 0.285. The slot on the tailstock piece is about 0.15. This is a 25mm length, so I'll probably cut it in half, and then I'll machine off the threads until it just fits into the slot. Okay, YouTube, I cut off about half of the screw there, and I screwed it into a nylon lock nut so I could chuck it up in my three jaw chuck. I got to round off the edge a little bit, so let's do that. Just barely machined off the threads, and I think that's going to work there. Ran a file up and down the edges of the groove there, and also tried to take down this place where it got dinged up a little bit, but I think that's pretty good. And now I can actually adjust that with finger. I don't need a tool to get in there. Okay, so here's the screw. This fits in there, and then there's two half-threaded holes. You can see there's half a hole there and half a hole there, and those line up with those two. They only go in one way, so you have to push this in and try it. And if the screws go in easy, you're in the right spot. If they don't, you've got to pull this out, flip it 180, and then put it in the other way, because they only line up one particular position. Okay, I think I got her lined up. You have to get it really lined up and then tap it in with a plastic hammer, and then you can run these M5 set screws in. There we go. So that's on there. And then you retain it with this, a nut with some flats on it, and then there's a set screw in the end that you use to lock it in place. Okay, here we go. Got the right size Allen for that. So yeah, then you just run this in, and I think this is another set screw I need to get a replacement for. It's pretty well stripped out too. And then you have to put the hand wheel on first. That's usually fine. It's going to engage that, but first you have to feel it start to thread in there. And then you've got to pull it in until you find that set screw. There we go. Now we got it. You got to feel the screw drop in the groove as you crank it in, but you've got to crank the thing in a little bit. Yeah, that's a lot nicer than it was. There's only a slight rocking. Now I don't even need a wrench to adjust that either, because this socket head cap screw has got a little bit of knurling on the head, so you can just run that, and that guy clears. So I think that's a good solution. Much stronger screw, and now without the threads on the very tip of it here, you've got a smoother part to go into that slot rather than having the threads. Because I think what happened before is all the threads got worn off the bottom of the set screw, and then it started rocking really badly, and the last time it just sheared it right off. I think I'm back in business. You got to fix this before you can work on anything else. Break a blade in the bandsaw, you have a part like this fail, and you've got to take a couple hours to shut down production and fix the machinery. I think that'll work good. So another little repair. Yeah, I definitely have to go through. I've got to replace those screws, the two little set screws. Yeah, that's definitely the way to go on that. Take a 6x1 socket head cap screw, cut it off to maybe about 10-12 millimeters long, knock a few threads off the end, and I think that's much better. Anyway, I thought I'd show you that quick repair. I got to get this back on the lathe and get back to work today. Any questions, post up in the comments section below, and I'll put some of the other lathe videos over there on the side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.